Builders D-Day for Marc Márquez and Fabio Quartararo. The Misano test allowed the five MotoGP factories to lay the foundations for their 2024 machines, with some telling comments afterwards, potentially helping shape the 2024 grid even further. All eyes were understandably on the Japanese manufacturers on Monday, with both Honda and Yamaha hoping the items they brought to Misano were a step forward in allowing them to close the gap to their European competitors. We start with Honda, where both Marc Márquez and Joan Mir were given the chance to try the machine that Stefan Bradl had used during the course of the San Marino Grand Prix weekend, which include a new chassis, a new tail unit, new exhaust system, but importantly didn't include a new and updated 2024 engine. The Spanish pair both said that the new machine required a very different riding style, but in the end the problems were more or less the same, with the pair saying that rear grip was still a huge issue for them. Márquez in particular said that he now has three options for his 2024 plans: a plan A, a plan B and a plan C, with a decision to be made inside the next 3 weeks around the time of both the Indian and Japanese Grand Prix. Taka Nakagami also got the opportunity to try that first 2024 prototype and ended the day as the top Honda, 12th overall for Nakagami, ahead of Márquez in 14th and Mir in 16th. As Honda go back to the drawing board as they try and keep hold of 8-time world champion Marc Márquez, Yamaha will walk away from the Misano test with a small smile on their face, according to team boss Mayo Merigali, after a brand new engine offered both more power and more rideability to the delight of the Iwata squad. That new engine wasn't the only thing they tested though, with a plethora of aerodynamic updates plus a new chassis as well, seeing the Yamaha boys sit quite comfortably on the timesheets. Fabio Quartararo ending the day 6th overall, just over half a second adrift of our test topper Luca Marini, with Franco Morbidelli less than a tenth behind the Frenchman in 8th. World champions Ducati were severely depleted today, with Pecco Bagnaia, Marco Bezzecchi, test rider Michele Pirro and outbound Fabio Di Gianantonio all sitting the test out, meaning the bulk of the work was given to San Marino Grand Prix winner Jorge Martin down at the Prima Pramac racing box. It was confirmed that Martin was testing some small parts as Ducati take their first steps towards building a 2024 package, but team boss Gino Borsoi remained tight-lipped afterwards as to the exact details of what the Spaniard was testing. He may have been the only rider down in the Mooney VR46 box, but Luca Marini ended the day as the fastest man, a 130.602, a quarter of a second away from Jorge Martin's lap record set in qualifying on Saturday, unofficially the second fastest ever lap around the Misano World Circuit Marco Simoncelli. Martin was fourth, with Alex Marquez also doing a little bit of work for Ducati, given their lack of riders. He ended the day 9th. Down at KTM, both Brad Binder and Jack Miller got the opportunity to try the carbon chassis that test rider Danny Pedrosa used throughout the weekend in San Marino, with the pair of them setting their fastest laps on the innovative new design. Binder was third overall and only half a second away from Marini, whereas Miller found over half a second on his fastest lap from the weekend to sit fifth on the timesheets and only 0.02 of a second behind his South African teammate. Finally, down at Aprilia, there wasn't too much to test for Aleix Espargaró and Maverick Viñales. However, the duo did get their hands on a brand new chassis that the Nuvali factory had brought. The big news was down in the R&F Aprilia box, where preparations for 2024 began for Miguel Oliveira as he got a chance to try the bike that both Aleix Espargaró and Maverick Viñales are currently using, which the R&F pair will jump onto for the 2024 season. Looking at the timesheets, Viñales ended the day 2nd overall thanks to a 130.836, with Miguel Oliveira 7th, Raul Fernandez 10th and Aleix Espargaró 11th. So that's the Misano test done and dusted, with the next opportunity for the MotoGP factories to try their 2024 packages coming at the end of the season at the Valencia test. But the big question ahead of that is, will Marc Marquez be confirmed as a Honda rider or potentially going elsewhere after what he tried today in Misano? Stick to MotoGP.com for all the latest news over the next 3 weeks when Marquez says he will be making his decision.